Good evening and welcome. I am happy to welcome to this evening's program a talk by Gurumurthy on Nateswara, the Lord of Dance. He has come all the way from Coimbatore for us. I welcome you, sir. The Pitamaha, the Padma Bhushan awardee, Dr. Nagaswamy, is here to preside and then give a small introduction to the subject as well as he will introduce the speaker. Welcome you, Dr. Sir. Madhuradhwani is basically a music organization, so we don't want to miss this opportunity. We want to start this program with a few songs on Lrod Nataraja. Lrod Nataraja. There are about, my friend Vaidyanathan says, there are about 50 songs that he could identify on Nataraja. So they are going to present 6 songs today by various composers. They will be sung by Shivani, Shobana, and Bharathi. They will be accompanied on violin by Subhashree and on Mridangam by Balaji. So let us listen to this song, then Sir will introduce the subject. Thank you.
Padam thookiyaadum idad padam thookiyaadum nadarajanadi padivaye nilje idad padam thookiyaadum nadarajanadi padivaye கை காண கண்ணாயிரம் வேண்டாமோ.
Hey.
Chidambaram, Bhusura Trita Amen. Yeah. Yeah. அருள் ஜோதி தெய்வமென்னே ஆண்டு கொண்ட தெய்வம் அருள் ஜோதி தெய்வமென்னே ஆண்டு கொண்ட தெய்வம் அருள் ஜோதி தெய்வமென்னே ஆண்டு கொண்ட தெய்வம் அம்பலத்தே அடைகின்ற
We have taken 10 minutes more than what we wanted, but we want these youngsters to sing in front of you. Very nicely sung. Thank you. If you have seen, there was one song from Thiruvarupa that was tuned by Sangeetha Kalacharya P.S. Narayan Swami, who is present with us. Welcome, sir. So these students have been trained by Vidwan C.R. Vaidyanathan. I request him to accept a small memento from us. I request you to present.
இந்த நிகழ்ச்சி நாதத்தில் ஆரம்பித்து தொடங்கிட்டு நாதம்ங்கிறதே பிரம்மம்னு சொல்கிறோம், நாத பிரம்மம்னு சொல்கிறோம். அந்த நாதத்தினுடைய எண்டை வந்து நாதாந்தம்னு சொல்கிறோம். அது நாதாந்த தாண்டவம்னு சொல்லுவார். நாதம் நாதாந்தம் இதுக்கு நடுவில் இருக்கிறது ஆனந்த தாண்டவம். ஆனந்தம்னாலும் பிரம்மம், நாதம்னாலும் பிரம்மம், தாண்டவம்னாலும் பிரம்மம். அதை பற்றி பேசுகிறதுக்காக கோயம்புத்தூர்லேருந்து நமது அன்பர் குருமூர்த்தி வந்திருக்கார். அவர் வந்து தொழில்துறையில் சிறந்தவர். தெலுங்கு மரபில் நியோகின்னு சொல்கிற அந்த பெரிய பரம்பரையில் விஜயநகர ராஜா காலத்திலிருந்து இங்கே வந்து தமிழோட தமிழாக ஒன்றி இருக்கிறவர். அவ பெரியவா தாத்தா தாத்தாவோட தாத்தாவெல்லாம் பூஜை பண்ணியிருக்க அத்தனை விக்கிரகங்களையும் வச்சுக்கிண்டு அவர் தினமும் ஒன்றும் பூஜை பண்ணிகிட்டு இருக்கக்கூடிய பெரிய சிவபக்தர். அவர் ஒவ்வொரு சிவராத்திரியும் போதும் காளஹஸ்தியில் ஆரம்பித்து எல்லா க்ஷேத்திரங்களுக்கும் பஞ்சபூத க்ஷேத்திரங்களுக்கும் போய் ராத்திரியில் முடிஞ்சு மறுநாள் காத்தால் வரக்கூடிய 20 வருஷம் தொடர்ந்து ஒரு 30-40 பேரை கூட்டின்னு போயிட்டு வந்த பெரியவர் அவர். அவர் வந்து வெள்ளிக்கிழமை இன்றைக்கு உட்காந்து பூஜை பண்ணுறதை பார்த்துட்டே இருக்கலாம். அவ்வளோ எதுக்காக அதெல்லாம் சொல்கிறேன்னா, இந்த சிலையை பார்க்குறதுன்னா இன்னமும் வெறும் சிலையை மாத்திரம் பார்க்கறது இல்லை, அது உள்ளேருந்து பக்தியிலிருந்து வந்து பார்க்கக்கூடிய இது. அதோடு கூட அவர் வந்து ஒரு அவுட்ஸ்டாண்டிங் ஃபோட்டோகிராஃபர், ஃபஸ்ட் கிளாஸ் ஃபோட்டோகிராஃபர். ஒரு சிலைன்னு சொன்னாக்க, ஒரு கோயில்னு சொன்னால் அது எப்படி பார்த்தா அதோட அழகை பார்க்கலான்னு அவ்வளோ அழகாக ஃபோட்டோகிராஃப், ஆயிரக்கணக்கான ஃபோட்டோகிராஃப் எடுத்திருக்கார். அவர் போகாத தேசமே கிடையாது. நம்ம தேசத்தில் இருக்கக்கூடிய கலைகளை மாத்திரம் இல்லை, ஃபாரீஸ்டில் இருக்கக்கூடிய கம்போடியா தாய்லாண்டு அந்த மாதிரி அத்தனை தேசத்துக்கும் போயிருக்கார். வெஸ்ட்டில் எல்லா தேசங்களுக்கும் போயிருக்கார். இப்போ கூட இஸ்ரேலுக்கு போகிறார். இந்த ஒரு 40-50 பேரை கூட்டிக்கிண்டு பெரியவாளெல்லாம் கூட்டிண்டு கோயம்புத்தூர்லேருந்து போட போகிறார். அதோடு கூட கோயம்புத்தூரில் பேரூரில் அந்த பெரிய கோயிலில் 24 வருஷமாக நாட்டியாஞ்சலி நடத்தின்னு வர்றார் அவர். அந்த மாதிரி ஆர்ட்டுக்கு பெரிய தொண்டாற்றியவர் வந்திருக்கார். இங்கே அவரோட கண்ணில் அந்த நம்ம சிலையெல்லாம் பார்த்தோன்னா, நட்ராஜா பார்த்தோம்னா, ஆனந்த தாண்டவத்தை பார்த்தோம்னா நம்ம பரமானந்தத்தை அனுபவிக்க முடியும், பக்தியை அனுபவிக்க முடியும். அவர் வந்திருக்கிறது நமக்கெல்லாம் பெருமையாக இருக்குது. அதுக்கு இடம் கொடுத்ததுக்கு அவர் ராமகிருஷ்ணன் அவர்களுக்கு நம்முடைய நன்றியை தெரிவித்து கொண்டு, குருமூர்த்தி கொஞ்சம் நீங்கள் வந்ததுக்காக வந்து இங்கிருந்து உங்களுடைய பேச்சை தொடங்கலாம் என்று கூறி விடைபெற்று விளங்குகின்றேன்.
My pranams to my guru, Dr. Nagaswamy. Leonard Scholars here. My dear friends, ladies and gentlemen, a very warm good evening to one and all of you. I should thank Mr. Ramakrishna for inviting me for giving this talk here in this prestigious RK Convention Center. And I'm very delighted and very happy to be here and give this presentation on the Nateswara today. This is a dedication to the eternal cosmic dancer Nateswara of Chidambaram. And today we'll see a beautiful PowerPoint presentation dealing in different aspects of Nateswara. Shiva is the Lord of Dance and he is known as Nateswara. The concept of Shiva's dance is not confined to the performance alone, but it's a depiction of the universal function. When you say it's Nateswara, it's not just a dance, but it's a universal function altogether. The dance is just not a symbol. It takes place within each of us at the atomic level, at every moment. The birth of this world, the maintenance, the destruction, the covering of the soul, revelation, all these five acts of this dance, all that are made will be unmade, and all that has been destroyed will be reassured. So this is the function of Nataraja's dance, Nateswara's dance. Now coming to dance, when did it happen? How did it happen? This is the first question we have. The Linga Purana and the Shiva Purana talk about Shiva as Tandava in four categories. The first thing they talk about is Rudra Tandava or Ugra Tandava. The second one is the Pralaya Tandava. The third one is Pradosha Tandava. And the fourth one is Ananda Tandava. Now, Shiva's Tandava, Ugra Tandava or Rudra Tandava, whatever you call it, is what which happened when Sati Devi went and immolated herself in the Daksha Pratapati's Yajna. The body was charred and Shiva took the body on his shoulder and he danced all over the Kailash in a very violent mood and the whole world was shivering with fear. And that was the dance of Shiva at Kailash, which is known as Ugra Tandava or the Rudra Tandava. The second Tandava of Shiva is the one that happened in the cremation ground with all the Bhuta, Preta, Prashasha, Yakshas, Ganas, everybody at the end of the Pralaya. To end the Pralaya and to start the life again, he does the dance in the cremation ground and that is what is called as Pralaya Tandava. Shiva's third dance is that one which happened with Gauri at the evening hour, the dusk. On the golden throne of Kailash Mountain, the evening, the entire Kailash Mountain glitters like gold and he accompanied with all the celestials playing the different types of musical instruments like Vishnu playing the Kudamula, Nandi playing the Mridangam, Vani playing the Veena and everybody enjoying in that particular beautiful ambience there, Shiva did this wonderful dance and that's called the Pradosha Tandava which happened in Kailash. And you all know about the story of Dharukavana where the rishis were all steeped in Mimamsa and they were against all this worship. Shiva wanted to teach them a lesson and he came there as Bhikshadana and these rishis and all the rishipatnis went behind him and the rishis went behind Mahavishnu accompanied him as Mohini and they were all insulted. They got insulted and they did Abhichara and sent out lot of weapons and animals to destroy Shiva and Shiva took them as Abharanas and he had everything adorned by himself and then he started dancing there in bliss. And that is to bless these rishis of the Tarakavana and that is what you call as the Ananda Tandava. These are the four major Tandavas which are dealt in the Shiva Purana and the Linga Purana. Now, there's a sloka which goes, Sankirtanajadam Hindu Hema Kurari Mundastiti Deva Baha Svetarka Dumaraja Pinkchakadharam Vyagra Kritim Param Sarpam Sadhyakare Abhayam Damarukam Vamam Prasthanyakam Vamegam Dandakam Sayana Brishta Apasmara Prishtestitam Vajrakatabhya Dakshinam Tucharanam Chaudharya Vamam Padam Madhyaste Dvajakinkini Manitula Kotistupura Padukam Dakshe Nakara Kundalam Sutipute Vametu Patran Vithim Basmalpitam Umayuktam Tranayanam Vande Natesham Shivam. This is the sloka of Nateshwara which happened. And what does it mean? It's a very simple meaning that goes with Nateshwara as what has been explained in the sloka. I salute to Nateshwara, who's with his matted locks flowing around and studded with golden crescent moon on it. The skull, the Ganga, the white arka flowers, and the feather of the cranes decorate his head and the matted locks of Nataraja. He wears the tiger skin around the waist as if he's wearing a silken garment, and the right hand he holds a snake and the Abhaya Mudra and a little Damarukam. While one on the left is extended, pointing to the raised foot, and the other he holds a stand of and stands on the back of the Apasmara Purusha, and his right leg planted firmly on that and lifted up, and the chain of bells are hanging 18 in his legs. He wears the Nakara Kundala on the right ear and the Patra Kundala on the left ear. With his third eye and the basma smeared all over the body, he performs the dance with Uma, and that is Natesha. This is a sloka which gives a vivid description of Nataraja or Nateshwara. The Saivam talks about threefold philosophical concept of Shiva, which is seen in three different forms and visualized. Mahesham Shankalpoitam Vimishyaram tu Sadashivam Nishkalam Shivam Yekam tu Ananda Triti Bhavayet Tasmat Ananda Rupatu Nitya Murti Ityochati. Mahesha is the one who is visualized with limbs, body, etc. Sadashiva, who is visualized in a form or is also without any form. Nishkala is that one without any attributes and seen as Ananda or the bliss. And that Nishkala Rupam is Nateshwara. Nateshwara is the Nishkala Rupam of Shiva, who performs the Ananda Tandava all over the space. Nateshwara is the dancing Shiva. He is known as Nrityeshwara. In the Uttara Kamika Agama and other, he has been referred by the name also as Nirthya Murthy. Inscriptions of Rajaraja at the temple of Thinjavur says him as Adavallan, the master dancer. The Lord of Chitambaram was referred as Tiruchitrambalam Udayar and the Devi as Tirukamakotattu Udaya Periyanayaki in all the inscriptions of the Cholas. Today he is known more as Nataraja, and all the Shiva temples have Nataraja and the pujas are performed there as stated in the Kamika Agama. The early Tamil works of Shiva, Tamil works called Shiva's dances, Kuttu, and Shiva is also referred as Kuttan. The name Nataraja appears much later, only during 13th century. This is what been said by everybody. But there are minor references of what Shiva was, Nritya Murthy was called as Nataraja also earlier. However, Panini in a Shiva Sutra describing the emergence of sound that came of Damaru of Shiva all as Bijakshiras, he says, Nritya Vasane Nataraja Rajo Nanadi Datkam Navapancha Varnam. So, Nataraja Rajo, he says, Panini says in his Sutra. And the word Nataraja denotes Shiva as the king of dance, Natya. There is specific mention of dancing Shiva as the king of dance. The verses of Tirunyanasamundar in his Tevaram of 6th century, he very clearly says, it is Nataraja. Mandar Shudalai Podi Pusi Mayanath Teendan Nadanam Aadiya Vendan Tanmeni Neendan Iruvarku Eri Aai Aravu Aram Poondan Nagar Poom Pugali Nagar Thane. Samantar says Shiva as a king of dance, Nadanam Aadiya Vendan, which is very clear that it is meant to be Nataraja in his Tevaram of the Pompugali, and he calls it very clearly Nateshwara as Nataraja, the king of dance. Natya was an integral part of her culture. Nrityam was a part of her ocular sacrifice from the Vedic times. Nrityam and music, particularly to set to the chant of Samavedic hymns and to the tune of Veena, was an essential part of the Vedic yajnas that were happening during the Vedic times. Sage Bharata explains that there is no theme that cannot be depicted in a sculpture or a painting, and that can be only intercepted with the language of Natya. Natya language alone can intercept the beauty of any sculpture or painting or whatsoever is being created. The language of Natya is so important that you can really appreciate and know more about that particular sculpture or painting whatsoever. The dance of Shiva is known as Tandava, and Shiva performs this Tandava in the rhythmic pattern, adding grace and purpose to the performance. The dance of Shiva is codified by Tandu under his direction, and it was passed to sage Bharata, who authored the great Natya Shastra, which is known as the Panchama Veda. Bharatanatya Shastra classifies Tandava as the combinations of karanas and explains about 108 different types of karanas, which are also dealt in the Saiva Agamas. And that we saw is the new 108 karanas, which is there in the temple of the great Rajaraja built at Tanjavur. Sambandar in another Tevaran specially mentioned Shiva's performance as Chokkanirtha. In the Panchabhutas, he says that Shiva does this Chokkanirtha in the Panchabhutas along with Uma. Chokkanirtha is also called as Suddhanirtha. Shiva taught this to Nandikeshwara, and who in turn taught it to Bharata, and this was what classified as 108 Nityakaranas. Nityakaranas are nothing but a combination or combined with gentle movements known as the Nritya Abhinaya. Sambandar says in his Tevaram as Chokkanirtate, where Shiva performed this Chokkanirtyam at the Sandhya Kala. That's the evening time he performed the Suddhanirtya, and that's what he talks about it. Natya Shastra distinctly mentions about both males and females to have to master this art of Natya. Male dancing gives support to the limbs, which are very useful in the warfare. Although Shaiva Agamas say about 108 forms of Tandava of Shiva, it restricts the depiction of 9 modes of Tandava alone. These 9 modes of Tandava are depicted in the sculptural bronze forms as Nritya Murthy or Nataraja, and they are worshipped in the temples all over our country. Shiva, Nataraja is the supreme form of Shiva, and he is represented in the Ananda Tandava Rupa, which are commonly found in the temples. Nataraja image denotes that Shiva is the supreme god, and his dancing pose of Ananda Tandava denotes the Panchakrityas, Shrishti, Sriti, Samhara, Anugraha, and Tirobhava. And this sloka goes like this. Damarukam Srishti Rupam Tu Bhujangam Sthiti Rupakam Samharam Agni Rupam Tu Tirobhavam Tu Kunchitam Abhayam Anugraham Kapi Panchakritya Swarupakam. Shiva's Panchakritya is explained in this beautiful sloka, where it is talking about Srishti, Sthiti, Samhara, Anugraha, and Tirobhava. What is this? What is this Panchakritya? The right upper hand, he holds a damaru. That damaru, the sound that emerged from damaru, is what denotes a creation and evolution, and that's called the Srishti. The damaru, the Big Bang theory, we all talk about science today and say the whole world and all everything creation started with the Big Bang. So the bang, the sound, that's the creation, is what is shown here in the damaru, and that Shiva plays the damaru and it gives the sound, and that is the start of the Srishti. The upper hand is holding Agni. Left upper hand is Agni, Agni. A spark of fire he holds. A fire is a destructive one and is also a constructive one. The spark can be destructive also. At the time of destruction is required, it can become a big, huge catastrophe. So that destruction is denoted by the fire which he holds in his hand. And the right hand, he shows the Abhaya, denotes that I am the person, look, I am going to protect you. I am the savior for you. And I am going to take care of you. And that's the symbol which he gives with the right hand as protection. Now, when do we get the protection? How do we get the protection from him? How do we get his grace? That's what he's showing there as Sthiti. Pointing out his raised foot very clearly and said, look, you come and surrender here at my foot. Then I'll take care of you. The right foot is on top of Avasmara, representing illusion or Thirobhava. What is that? When do you go and surrender? You have to leave your ego behind. Everything has to be shed out. And you go and have a complete surrender at the foot of Nataraja. He takes care. And he is the master who creates and the master who destroys. And he is the Supreme Lord. That's what is meant in the figure of Nataraja. The image of Nataraja denotes the most minute atom and also the mighty universe in one. This is phenomenal. This is very, very phenomenal, where Nataraja's image denotes the smallest thing, atom, and the mightiest thing, universe, both in one. As an atom, if you imagine yourself as an atom, the image of Nataraja is the nucleus, the center part of it, and the Prabha Mandala denotes all the electrons, neutrons and protons moving around this nucleus, all goes in a rhythmic speed and goes around that. Then that is what is the center part, is the Lord Nataraja, and that Nataraja is not static. The nucleus of an atom is always vibrating and there is always a movement. That movement of the nucleus part of it is the dance of Nataraja. That's what's happening, and everything goes around that. And if you consider all the flames that we see around the Nataraja's image as representation of this gallery, and they are all moving out around that center part of Nataraja in an orbit which is very rhythmic and very well-set matter. Very well-set manner it moves around very beautifully without colliding with each other, without touching each other, happily it moves around. The entire system is functioning so smoothly, and the whole thing is controlled by a great force, and that galaxy is happening, everything is happening in that, and that is Nataraja, who's controlling the entire movement, and he is representing the entire universe. So the atom and the universe is both seen as one Nataraja. And that's what we call them as cosmic dance. The image of Nataraja is a representation of atom and animal and universe, we said. CERN, the European Organization of Nuclear Research, Geneva, has a 6-foot image of Nataraja at the entrance to prove the world that Nataraja is the cosmic dancer. Anand Kumaraswamy, a great art historian, seeing beyond the unsurpassed beauty of Nataraja, says, it is the earliest image of God in action which no art or religion can boast of. he says that this is one of the greatest creation that any other art form has created anywhere in this world. Firjof Skapra, who is the author of the great book Tao of Physics and is a great physician, physics person, says modern physics has shown that the rhythm of creation and destruction is not only manifest in the turn of seasons in birth and death of all living creatures, but also on the inorganic matter for the physicist then. So all the inorganic matter also has the circle going on. And Shiva's dance is that dance of that subatomic matter which happens all around. And Capra says that what 1,000 years back we created in bronze image of Nataraja, physics of our time have used the most advanced technology to portray the patterns of cosmic dance. Now, the dance of Shiva, whatever you see here, is beautifully portrayed, and the physicists now say that it has got so much of similarity. And that, he says, it unifies the modern day, physics with that of the mythology. Both goes hand in hand. And the image of Shiva denotes him as the representation of the Panchabhutas also. Nataraja is an embodiment of the five elements, Appu, Teyu, Prithvi, Vayu and Akasha. Agni is denoted by the flame and the which he holds in his hand, and also the Prabha Mandala. The whole thing is energy. The fire is the energy there. That is Nataraja. Akasha is seen as a space around the image of Nataraja, where Shiva, the dancer Nataraja, happens in the outer space. That's what Aveda talks about. And Prithvi is represented by the lotus pedestal which he's standing. He's standing on top of the Apasmara Purusha, who is on the lotus pedestal. That denotes the Prithvi Tattvam. And Vayu is seen in the fluttering jatas of Shiva while dancing, and also the fluttering waistcloth that he wears. And Appu is seen as a representation of two makaras that emerge from the either side of the Prabha Mandala. The two makaras which come there and the Prabha Mandala happens, that is what is represented as the Appu, the water theme or water tattva of Shiva. The dance of Shiva is the one that consists of the five elements, is what Tirumular says. Tirumular, who enjoyed the dance of Shiva, he says, Kaliyodu Adi Kanakachalathadi, Kuriyodu Adi Kuvelayate Adi, Nidya Nir Tikkal Nirvan Idayadi, Nalura Ambalate Adum Nadane. He says in his Tirumandiram very beautifully, and the meaning that it conveys is phenomenal. The sparks, the sparkling gems and the diamonds that are there inside the earth, which we do not see, they all sparkle. They are a dance. The splashing waves of the ocean, the beautiful way, rhythmic waves, are very, very high tides and low tides that we see in a different motion. They are all the dance of Shiva. The flames of the gulping fire, which is so beautiful to look at it, it's also a rhythm, a dance of Shiva. The breeze, the gentle breeze, tendril, katru, and the cyclonic storm that comes and hits like tsunamis, they are also a type of dance that happens in the nature, and that's the dance of Shiva. The flashing lightning that happens on the space that you see here, deafening lights come for fractions of second and goes away. And that is also an act of dance, and that's the dance of Shiva. And this is all the nature that performs every day, everywhere. And all that is the dance of Shiva, which he performs in Tillayambalam. He says it beautifully in his Tirumandiram. Tirumoolar enjoyed the dance of Shiva in all the aspects inside him and also outside him. You see, all actions that is happening in the nature as a dance of Shiva, and he calls them as Shivananda Koothu, Sundara Koothu, Purpadi Koothu, Poonthillai Koothu, Arpuda Koothu, are all different types of dances that Shiva had performed. He explains this wonderfully in his Tirukoothu Darisinam. The tattva and the iconography of all these koothus are explained wonderfully in the 82 stanzas of this great poem that Tirumoolar has composed. Now, coming to the iconography of Shiva, there's something phenomenal that you should know. What is the beautiful iconography of Shiva, and how it's been there, and how they have created exactly what is mentioned in that Silpa Shastras? Amsabheda Agama describes very clearly that Nataraja images are to be made only in bronze as Utsava Murthis, or the processional deities. These images have to be made in Uttama Dasatala measurements, thereby giving a graceful and majestic look to the thing. The Ashtatala, they say, if you see the eight times the face is the whole entire body, suppose you make it 10 times the face, it may look odd, but that too, the Uttama Dasha, the best of the 10 times is what you do it, it looks so beautiful. If you see this Nataraja image here, it is Uttama Dasatala. But you will not find that anything which is totally out of order or anything, nothing, you don't feel that the limbs are elongated, nothing. But that is how it is to be made in Uttama Dasatala appearance. Nataraja images are always to be accompanied by Devi Parvati in the name of Shivakama Sundari. Nataraja with his consort are always housed separately in a hall called the Sabha Mandapam, facing south in all the Shiva temples. The upper hand should hold the Agni can be held in the cup or in the plain palm, like this. The Agni can be at the end of the palm or at the center, but it should be placed exactly on the root of the middle finger. It says very clearly, at the root of the middle finger is what is the place for Agni to be kept there. The left hand of Nataraja should hold the Dandahasta or the Gajahasta. And the left hand is to be always positioned across the body and the palm pointing down to the raised foot. The front right hand has to be held in the Abhaya Mudra pose. The middle finger should be positioned prominently, showing the Hika Sutra. This is Hika Sutra is something on a direction, 45 degree angle, something like that, it comes as. It's Hika Sutra. In that sutra or that line is what is the position of the hand should be there. Look at this beautiful hand. Everything is so beautifully seen. And the front forearm should have the Sarpa Vayala. The hissing snake should be tied around the first Abhayahasta. That is very clearly said. Look at that. The upper right arm should be holding the Damaru. The Damaru is to be held by the fingers in a striking pose, denoting the emergence of sound. It cannot be just shown like that. The Damaru should be held in Shiva's hand with the fingers like that, as if it is in a striking force, and that is going to emerge sound out of it. It should be very clearly there in that position. And there should be a cobra open hooded to be coiled around the Damaru. The right leg of Shiva is slightly bent and placed firmly on the back of Apaspara Purusha. And Shiva has to be adorned with the anklets and the ankle of the both legs and the feet. the left leg has to be raised and lifted. The knee should reach the nabi, Nabi Sutra. The knee, the lifted leg, it should reach the Nabi Sutra at the place of the navel and then turn down, bend down. The lifted leg should be towards the right leg and kept across. And the raised foot is called the Kunchita Padam. What a beautiful thing. Kunchita Pada Darshanam is what is most important thing in the Nataraja image, and that's called the Kunchita Padam. Shiva's head is to be with Jatamakutam and to be adorned with flowers and garlands. The jatas are to be decorated with Dadura or the Umattampu, which we called, and the Arka flowers. Jeweled ornaments are to be placed on the forehead and the snake, a human skull, and the crane feathers should be added to the head as a decoration, as a part of the decoration of the Jatamakuta. A crescent moon is to be tied to the left of the Jatamakuta. See, it says very clearly, it should be tied. It is not that you don't really have to make the crescent moon in the image itself. You can make it in silver and also tie it in the Jatamakuta. The jatas have to be in the number of 5, 7 or 11 and should be spread either side horizontally or in a circular fashion. And the body of Shiva is to be represented with the Yajnopavita and Urasutra, the chest band that he is to wear is what is there. The face of Shiva should be always shown smiling. Saffron and sandal paste to be smeared on the chest, and basma to be smeared all over the rest of the body of Shiva. Nataraja should be represented with rings on the fingers of the toes, except the middle finger and the middle toe. All the other fingers and the toes will have to have the rings. Very clearly seen. See there. It's very clear in this image, except barring the middle finger, all the other fingers have the rings, beautiful rings on the thing. Both the legs have to be adorned with anklets, that is tande, and the belt anklets, which is called the kolusu. Look at that, kolusu and tande, both are there. And the hands will be decorated with plain kankanas. The Apasmara Purusha under the Shiva's foot should have his face to the right and the legs to be left of Shiva. And he should be shown playing with a cobra in his right hand, and the left hand should be shown as if he is holding a cup. The Apasmara's face should be lifted up as if he is looking at Shiva. And Shiva has to be represented in a Prabhamandala with 27 or 54 flames. The whole image has to be presented on top of the lotus pedestal, and Devi Uma Parameshwari always to be placed left of Nataraja separately, and she is known as Shiva Kama Sundari. Friends, I would like to tell you, I have seen hundreds and hundreds of Nataraja images. But what is said in Amsaveda Agama clearly fits into the Nataraja image, one image which we saw here today. This is from a temple called Kolumam, very close to Coimbatore, about 70-80 kilometers from. Huge Nataraja, he has never moved out of the Siddhasthanam, he's almost 6.5 feet. This perfectly fits. And some other places, you have some other small variations, but whatever is said in this, perfectly fixed. And my guru Dr. Nagaswamy also happened to live his early days there in this Kolumam, and I had the opportunity to do this photograph of this great Nataraja with him as when I visited this place with him. The Uttarakamika Agama adds very many details to the iconography of Nataraja. It says Shiva should be represented with four arms with the objects as described earlier, and Shiva should be seen with a third eye. Jetas have to be spread around the Makuta. They can vary from 5 to 30 and should be at the intervals. And these intervals have to be decorated with Dardura and Arka flowers. Ganga in the form of a mermaid with folded hands, Anjali Hasta, should be seen on the right of the Jetta, and the crescent moon will be on the left. The image of Shiva should be adorned with many necklaces around his neck. Necklaces of pearls, snakes, Vakula flowers, seashells, boar tusk, tiger claws, and finally with the string of beads and a shell of the tortoise as its pendant. That is also to be adorned on Shiva. Look at the wonderful ornaments that Shiva is liking. He doesn't like all that beautiful gold things. All very simple, beautiful shells, shell of tortoise, and all the flowers that are available, tiger claws, boar tusk, everything, all this. Very simple thing is what our Shiva likes. The upper garment should be of the tiger or deer skin. At times it can be on the textured cloth. The left earlobe of Shiva should have the Patra Kundala and the right earlobe should have the Makara Kundala. And most of the times you find the elongated earlobe left plain to be adorned with the gold ornaments in the temples. Nataraja's left foot is to be represented in Bhujangatrasa. Agamas also state that Devi Uma should be on the left of Nataraja. It also states to the right of Nataraja image, Bringi or Bhadrakali has to be placed. Today, many temples we find the image of Patanjali or Vyagrapada or some other rishis, like in Coimbatore we have the Perur, we have the Gomuni and Pattimuni, and some rishis which are associated with the Shaktram, they are also there. And most of the places we find Manikavashagar to be always on the right of Nataraja. What is Bhujangatrasa? Abhinava Guptacharya, commentator of Bharata's Natyashastra, says on Bhujangasastras like this. When a dancer is dancing, while dancing, suddenly lifts his leg as though he has discovered a snake very near him and appears to be in a state of very unsteady gait. You know, suddenly we are dancing, suddenly you find a snake there right below your foot, and there is so much of a thing in that, in the unsteady manner you lift the leg. And that particular position of lifting the leg in a very unsteady manner is what is called as Bhujangatrasa. And he says that one hand should be in the Dolahasta, that the hand should be in Dolahasta and the other one should be the Katakahasta. And the Dolahasta that should hang freely from the shoulder should be in the Patakasta, that plane. It should have a plane hasta, should be there. This is what is called as Bhujangatrasa. The Makuta Agama and the Kamika Agama speaks about five different forms of Bhujangatrasa. Bhujangatrasa Rupam, Bhujanga Lalitam, Bhujanga Bhairavam, Bhujanga Vyalam and Bhujanga Kunchitam. Both these Agamas put together talk about this five, whereas Makuta Agama or the Kamika Agama talks about three. Thirinyana Sambandhar in his Thevaram mentions Nataraja's dance as Bhujangatrasa Matanam. He says very beautifully in his Thevaram that Nataraja did the Bhujangatrasa Matanam. Bhujangatrasa pose is the most popular pose of Nataraja that we see in this Tamil country. And Karikalamyar prays to Shiva that she should be under the foot of his dancing foot, raised foot. She should be there. The trinity of Thevaram, Thirinyanasambandhar, Appar and Sundarar have experienced the dance of Shiva and have sung in praise of the god's dance in their Thevarams. Cheraman, Piraman, Nayanar, who was blessed to hear the sound of the bells of Shiva's dance, every day in his anklets bells, he used to hear it. And he was blessed by Chidambaram Nataraja, and he sang the great Ponvanna Andadi on the Dance of Shiva. Nambi and Arnambi, Pattinathar, and many have shared the experience, and they have experienced the Dance of Shiva. The Dance of Shiva is Tandava. Agamas and scriptures talk about very elaborately about seven such Tandavas. They are known as Sapta Tandavas. These were performed by Shivara on different occasions with Uma, and he did it, performed it alone also. These Tandavas were performed by Shiva using the 108 Karana. Apart from the seven Tandavas, scriptures also talk about many other Tandavas. The Kamika Agama talks about seven Tandavas. There are minor variations in the above. And in the different scriptures, they call it by different names. The Ananda Tandava, the Sandhya Tandava, Gauri Tandava or Uma Tandava, Tripura Tandava, Kali Tandava or Urdhva Tandava, Munit Tandava or Shankara Tandava, and the Sambhara Tandava. These are the seven Tandavas which have been talked elaborately. Kayate Shiva Shreshtus Nityam Sapta Vidhanam. Bhavayet Ananda Tandavam Purvam Sandhya Tandavam Tatparam. Gauri Tandavam Evam Tu Tata Tripura Tandavam. Kali Tandavam Chaiva Muninam Tasya Tandavam. Sambhara Tandavam Chaiva Iti Sapta Tandava. The seven Tandavas are beautifully mentioned here in this wonderful sloka of Shiva. The Ananda Tandava Rupa. The Dance of Shiva in the bliss or joy performed at Chidambaram is the Ananda Tandava. Shiva with four arms, with upper hands holding Damaru and Agni, and the right front hand looking Abhyasta, and the left hung across pointing to the left foot. The right foot bend and the knee slightly and firmly fixed on the back of Apasmara is represented with Prabha Mandala or the Agni Jwala. This wonderful depiction of Ananda Tandava Rupa is the creation of the great Cholas on the basis of Saiva Siddhanta, denoting the Panchakrityas and the cosmos in one. Now let's see the Ananda Tandava sculptures. What a beautiful depiction of Ananda Tandava Rupa of Shiva by the great king Rajaraja in his temple of Tanjavur. What a beautiful depiction of it. It's a marvelous depiction of Ananda Tandava Rupa by Rajaraja. And his son, the great Rajendra, he made a wonderful, even one step ahead of him, he did this Ananda Tandava Rupam in the temple of Gangaikonda Cholapuram. There, he gives a very elaborate story of the whole thing happening. Shiva is dancing there. Devi Parvati Uma is there. She is watching the dance, reclining on the bull. On the edak, down below, Mahavishnu is playing the Kudambula, the Panchamukha Vadyam. Right above him, the Ganapati and the Subramanya are there watching it. The Bhutaganas are all dancing along with Shiva down below. And there's the frail lady Karakalamya right sitting there down below and playing the cymbals for the Dance of Shiva. And Shiv Kali image is also there behind. You can see the Kali image also behind Nataraja. And that depicts the beautiful Tandava or the dance competition that happened between the Kali and Shiva at the place called Tiruvalangadu. To represent that this happened in Tiruvalangadu, you have the beautiful tree behind the Nataraja image, which is still there. And this is the beautiful Nataraja at the temple of Tirunellam, created by the great queen Chembiyan Mahadevi. And she had created this Nataraja image in all the koshtas in the temples that she had renovated and rebuilt all over the Tamil country. And this is an excellent Nataraja. Much later period of Chola, during Vikrama Chola, there was a temple that he had built called Tukkachi. In there, in the koshtas of this temple, he has made this beautiful image of Nataraja. Unfortunately, the legs and the arms are all broken. Look at the way they have done that. It's made so beautifully like that of a bronze image. Look at the smiling face of Nataraja. Look at the spread out hair and the Prabha Mandala, everything. All made with such a wonderful polished granite stone as the Koshta image. Today, unfortunately, we could enjoy only a portion of it. Had it been a full image as what was conceived and made in those times, I will tell you there is nothing in par with this in this world. I would say that is the greatness of this wonderful masterpiece that has been created by the Vikrama Chola in the temple of Tukachi. And look at this. This is a Nataraja with a different, totally different hairstyle. This is the time of Rajaraja. He created this beautiful temple at Tiruvaliswaram, right in the Pandya country near Tirunelveli. And there, he has got only 15 sculptures on the Vimana. An amazing temple. Each sculpture is worth a million words of praise. I'm not talking about cash. Million words of praise. To that extent, it's such a beautiful temple that he has created, and the Ananda Tandava Murthy there in the temple of Tiruvaliswaram, created by Rajaraja, and a wonderful Nataraja image of very late period during 17th century by the Nayaks in the, what do you call that, Kambathadi Mandapam of the Madurai temple. So Shukanathar temple there is seen there. And these are all the images of Ananda Tandava Nataraja. Now we see him in the bronze. The most beautiful bronze was created for Nataraja is from the beginning of the 9th century they have been creating. The Cholas, right from Aditya period, they have been creating. But one of the most excellent bronze that has been created is by Rajaraja, which is still under worship in the big temple. What a beautiful bronze. And he called it as Adavallan. What a great dancer. He is the one who can dance. So great dancer. And that Adavallan and Shivakamasundari, what a beautiful creation of Rajaraja of 10th century, which is still under worship in the big temple of Tanjavur. And again, this is a closer image of that. And this is the temple known at, as Adichidambaram. It is in Tiruvenkadu. Tiruvenkadu, it is known as Adichidambaram. And the image of Nataraja is exactly in the similar way as you see it in the Chidambaram temple. The hairstyle of Nataraja, the image of Nataraja is exactly a Xerox copy of what is available in Chidambaram temple and built during the time of Aditya. It's a very beautiful bronze, a very old bronze, and Devi Kishivakamasundari has the two maids, the Devi Lakshmi and Saraswati are her maids. They are her friends who are on the either side of it. A very rare phenomenon that you could see here in this Adi Chidambaram temple of Tiruvenkadu. This is an amazing early period Nataraja. Still under worship now in the temple of Kumbakonam, Nageswara Swami temple. A huge Nataraja, almost about 8 feet, 7 feet or 8 feet, I would say. Very beautiful Nataraja which is there. And what is beauty is that this Nataraja was casted. There is a kinkini hanging right in the waist. A beautiful chain with a bell there. It is casted along with the ring. It's not made separately and inserted there. It is casted with that. What a great workmanship of that. Amazing Nataraja. And the beauty here is not only that, the Devi Shivakamasundari is not in the regular pose. But here she is in a pose where she is doing the Thala for Nataraja's dance. Her hands are as if she is making the thala. And Mahavishnu is playing the flute and so many other things are there. A very beautiful representation of Nataraja Murthy in Ananda Tandava pose at the temple of Nageswara Swami at Kumbakonam. Now let's see some more worship, bronzes under worship. This is from the temple of Koneri Rajapuram, which is built by the Chembiyan Mahadevi. There are many stories to say that this is a self-manifested image of Nataraja as the casted Nataraja came up. And today it is said this Nataraja has got the small marus or the, what do you call, marks that we have in the body. Molds and marks there is still there in that the image. Let's say a huge Nataraja of the world. This was one of the oldest Nataraja, which is such a huge one, 8 feet tall Nataraja, and a very beautiful Nataraja in this. Can again you see the close up of it? It has got the maru there, the black spot there. It's the maru of Nataraja. And look at the smiling face of Nataraja. A fantastic piece of Nataraja. And this is again one beautiful Nataraja which is in a place called Ananda Tandavapuram. This is also a very early period Nataraja. Here, the beauty of this Nataraja is that he holds the Kataka Hasta and the Dola Hasta, whatever the Gaja Hasta, is not to the side but coming right to this front. And the leg is not tilted to the side, the leg is also lifted to the front. It's a very beautiful, very early period Nataraja. Must be as early as about before 9th century or 10th century this Nataraja is set. And the hairstyle is totally different. He doesn't have the flowing hairs or anything. It's more like a kirita makutam and everything. This was buried inside the thing and somewhere in the temple complex and it was found out. It's a very old Nataraja which is under worship at a place called Ananda Tandavapuram, very close to Mayiladuthurai. Or rather the outskirts of Mayiladuthurai. Another beautiful Nataraja of the Ananda Tandava Rupam, which is still now under the worship at the temple of Chepparai. This is a Chola bronze, which is in the Pandya country, in Tirunelveli, Chepparai. That's a beautiful Nataraja. That Nataraja is amazing. And finally, this is the beautiful Nataraja, which is now under worship in our temple of Mele Chidambaram, and I have go so much of regards. I've been admiring this Nataraja from my childhood days. He is the one who gave me all the interest in life for me to do all these things. He beautifully sets into the wonderful Tevaram of Upper, where he says, Kunitta Puruvamam Kovvai Shivvayil Kuvinch Virupum பனித்த ஷடையும் பவழம் போல் மேனியில் பால் வெண்ணீரும் இனித்த உடன் எடுத்த பொற்பாதமும் காணப்பெற்றால் மனித்த பிறவியும் வேண்டுவதே இம்மாநிலத்தை. எக்ஸாக்ட்லி டு தட் வேர்ட்ஸ் ஆஃப் வாட் அப்பர் ஹெட் செட், திஸ் இமேஜ் இஸ் தேர். லுக் அட் திஸ் குனித்த புருவம் குவை சிவாய் குவின் சிரிப்பும் வாட் ஸ்மைல் இயர்ஸ் காட் இனித்த உடன் எடுத்த பொற்பாதமும். அண்ட் வென் வி சே பனித்த ஷடை, the jeta is not flowing on to the either side, the dance, it's just flowing down. Panitta shade is not just the hanging thing, it moves like a snake. It just, the snake's movement is just like that, swift. The hair is flowing swift there, and that's the panitta shade. I've enjoyed this Nataraja in every bit of it during the abhishekams. What a classic piece it is. I will tell you, if you see as an art, it is surpasses everything. If you see him as a god, he's one above everything. You are there, he can chat with you. To that extent, I'll tell you, we have had the experience of this great Nataraja. Sandhya Tandavam is the next Tandavam, where Shiva with four arms and three eyes and Jata Mukutam and Abhayahasta with the right hand, he does this. The damaru on the upper right hand and the left hand with the peacock feather and Vishmita Udra. See, this is all the descriptions that they give about the Sandhya Tandavam. The left leg bend and the other has to be bent, and they should be with the peetam, with or without apasmara, all these things. But most of this are not there in many of these things. Now what you see here is a Sandhya Tandavam murti created by the Rajaraja in his big temple of Tanjavur. You see this beautiful dancing murti on the Sambadam. It is called the Sandhya Tandava Murti. And you have the Uma Tandavam, Shiva with three eyes, Jata Makutam and six arms. Right side he holds the Damaru, Trishula and Abhayahasta. And the left side he is holding Kapala, Vishmaya Mudra and Gajahasta, Swanga Cross. He is dressed with all the ornaments, Ganga and the tiger skin around his waist. And his concert Uma is also accompanied. This is called as Uma Tandavam. Tripura Tandavam. Again, Tripura Tandavam is that Tandavam which Shiva did after the Samhara of the Tripurasuras. The dance he performed as a dance of victory. And Shiva did it on top of the chariot, and Devi Uma also joined him in the dance in the name Bharathi. And the Sangam epic of Silapadigaram talks about this dance as Pandarangam and Kodukotti. And the victory dance of Shiva was joined by Parvati, and later they emerged as one called the Ardhanari, and they became Ardhanari and they performed this wonderful dance. Shankara Tandavam. Shiva with three eyes and right arms fully open and spread the jeta and the makudam. He performs this. The left leg is planted back on Apasmara and the right foot is lifted above. The tiger skin around his waist. The right arms holding Damaru, Sula, Pasha, Abhaya, Hasta. And the left side holding Agni, Kapala, Gajahasta across. And Gauri is there to the left of Shiva and Nandi is there to the right of Shiva. This is Shankara Tandavam. The Kalika Tandavam or more no Ugrata Urdhva Tandavam. One face with three eyes and Jata Magudam spread across. Shiva dances this Tandava with eight arms. In this Tandava, Shiva's right leg is raised above and straight, and the left leg is slightly bent and placed on the back of Apasmara. The right leg holds the Damaru Sula Pasha Abhidaya. And the left sides are the Kapala, Agni, Bell and the Gajahasta across his torso. This is also known as a Chanda Tandava at times and Urdhva Tandava. Urdhva Tandava is that Tandava of Shiva which he performed along with Kali. Kali and Shiva had a competition of dance. To prove who was great in this dance, that competition was going tough and both were excelling each other. Finally, Shiva lifted his leg above his head. And Kali could not perform this feat and she conceded her defeat. And the Puranas talk about this competition which happened in the place called Tiruvalangadu. And that is the Urdhva Tanda Murthy of the great Kailashnatha temple. This is one of the most beautiful Urdhva Tanda Murthys which you find in our temple of Perur, Mele Chidambaram. And here Shiva is looked as Sadashiva or much more than that. Look at the beautiful Shiva sculpture image at Perur. And this is the one you see, the Urdhva Tanda Murthy at the Tenkashi temple. And this is again the Urdhva Tanda Murthy in the Pudumandapam of Madurai. And this is again the Urdhva Tanda Murthy in that Tadipatri temple. And this is again the Kailashnath temple we saw where Nandi is also dancing along with Shiva in the Urdhva Tandava. And this is the bronze of the Urdhva Tanda Murthy of Tiruvalangadu. Look at that Urdhva Tanda Murthy along with Kali. And this is a beautiful image of Urdhva Tanda Murthy of later period, much later. And Bharata Chudamani talks about the forms of dance called the Panchakritya Tandavas dedicated to them. These Tandavas are Agora Tandava, Urdhva Tandava, Saundarya Tandava, Amushya Tandava and Ananda Tandava. The Agamas talk about seven Tandavas and give the iconographic details of these. But today in our temples we find Nataraja of different types and not any of them fall into the above descriptions. All these Tandavas culminates one as one called the Ananda Tandava of Shiva, which is what is seen in most of the temples. Nritya Sabhas of Nataraja, the great Kanaka Sabha of Chidambaram, where he did this Ananda Tandava. The Rajita Sabha Kalmari Adiya Tandavam of, or called the Sandhya Tandavam, which happened in Madurai. The Urdhva Tandavam of Shiva, which happened in the Ratna Sabha of Tiruvalangadu. The Tamara Sabha, where Shiva did the Gauri Tandavam in Tirunelveli, and Chitra Sabha, where Nataraja is represented as Chitrapata. There is no image bronze or sculptural image of Nataraja. Here he is represented only as a Chitrapata, and that is in the Chitra Sabha of Tirukutralam, where he did the Tripura Tandavam. So the Pancha Sabhas of Nataraja is seen here very clearly. The scriptures also talk about different types of Tandavas, which are popular and not seen in the temples as sculptures and as bronzes. Nataraja images which we see in temples today and as sculptural representations are based more on the Nrityakaranas and not on the Tandavas. These sculptural representations have slight variations of the Nrityakaranas and have been executed in different styles according to the period of the stone, a period of the time when they had created this sculpture, the stone and the material that they have used. All these things, different type and different styles, add grace to the beautiful representation of Shiva being presented in different places in the Nityakaranas, what we see across the temples here. Chaturatandavam. Though this is called a Chaturatandavam, this is one of the Karanas of Shiva, although it's called a Tandava. Where, what is Chaturatandavam? Shiva dances with four or multiple arms on a playing ground or on top of Apasmara. Both the legs are bent and spread wide, and the foot is brought close. Thereby, the gap between the two legs gets the formation of a square. That is what is called as Chaturatandavam. This is a dance Karana, which is not a Tandavam. But this is called as Tandava, but this is basically a Karana. This is what you saw in the Patadakal temple of thing. This is again a Chaturatandava posture of Shiva, which is totally mutilated in the Patadakal temple. And this is a beautiful Chaturatandava posture of Shiva, which is there is a miniature in the temple of Pullamangai, very close to Tanjavur. It's a beautiful, small miniature. Mind you, this sculpture is just 6.5 inches. That's all. 6.5 inches by 6.5 inches. Where a wonderful creation of Chaturatandava with so many arms around, the limbs, everything has been created. And the Bhutakanas also along with that. What a marvelous creation it is. This happened about 300 years ago in Pullamangai. And the Chaturatandavam. This is again a beautiful sculpture at the temple of Tirumalapadi. It is called as Malavadiyar. But this is a beautiful Chaturatandavam. It is called Malavadiyar. There is a Samharatandavam also, you can call it. And this is again a Chaturatandava representation, one of the North Indian temples. And this is again what you find in the Ellora, Kailashnatha, Cave 16. On the back wall of the temple, you find this beautiful Tandava posture of Shiva in Chaturatandava. This is again a very rare representation of Chaturatandava pose in the Pandya country at Tirumalpur, in very close to what you call Srivalliputtur and other places. This is in Pandya country, Tirumalpur. It's there, very close to that Srivalliputtur and places. It's a Pandya country. It's a beautiful representation of that. And again, this is what is there in the Belur temple. Again, a Chaturatandava posture of Shiva. This is what you see, that Chaturatandava in bronze. This is from the temple of Kodumudi. The Kodumudi temple is a very old temple. It's called as Tenpandik Kodumudi. And the bronzes were created much before the Cholas. And that's the place where our Guru Dr. Nagaswamy hails from. And I had the opportunity to go and see this temple along with him in that places. Unfortunately, these were kept in dark places. We could hardly do any photographs. And lucky enough, I was able to trace this photograph somewhere else. And I'm seeing it. Look at this. This is an early pre-Chola bronze. Without Apasmara, he is dancing with four arms. And that is a Chaturatandava pose. There you see. Look at the legs. How beautifully he has placed it. wonderful way in which he has placed the legs and dancing. There is no upasmara. He is just dancing plain on the lotus pedestal. This is a amazing bronze, I would say. And again, a very beautiful bronze now in the National Museum from Thiruvarangulam in Pudukkottai district. What a beautiful bronze it is. Chatura Tandavam, exactly to the point. You cannot deviate an inch from this. As it is said, and as beautifully it's been represented, the Chatura Tandava pose is what you see in this wonderful bronze now on display at the National Gallery of New Delhi. An amazing, outstanding feature of Chatura Tandavam is what now we see here from Tirunallur. This is Shiva with eight arms dancing. He is not dancing on top of, on the back of Apasmara. He is dancing on right on the top of the head of the Apasmara Purusha. And this is a wonderful creation. This is also early Chola, or much earlier to Chola. The transition period is what they call it. And that period bronze, still under the worship at Tirunallur temple, now kept elsewhere for safety reasons. Once in a year he comes to Tirunallur. Once in a year for the festival time he is brought to Tirunallur. Amazing Nataraja. And today it's very rare to see such a wonderful bronze there of Chatura Tandava. And Lalita Tandava. They call it as Lalita Tandava. Lalita is again a posture of Bharatanatyam Karana. It is not a Tandava, but still they get the name Lalita Tandava. What is Lalita? This form of Karana is found in many of the sculptures. Wherever you go across the country, basically northern part of India, you find this particular posture of Karana all over the North Indian temples. It's called Lalita. Shiva's both foot are placed on ground and not on top of the apasmara. He's seen with four arms or multiple arms. One foot is placed on the ground and the other is bent, and the toe is touching the ground and the heel is raised in a tapping position. Shiva is dancing and he's tapping the thala also. That is the posture. This is called as Lalita. Look at this. This is again from that. What you saw there was a wonderful sculpture which was created by the Pulikesi in the Badami cave. What an amazing sculpture. I'll tell you, this sculpture, you can just talk for hours together about this wonderful sculpture. The posture in it is there. It's an amazing creation. I would say it's a masterpiece of Indian art today we have. And coming to, again, this Lalita pose is again from the Ellora temple, Ellora caves, again, which is again debated with the Rashtrakuta, Chalukya and all that. And this is again from Ellora. And you have this wonderful Lalita pose, probably belonging to the Chandela period, now somewhere in the museums across the world. And this is again Lalita Tandava in the Chalukyan cave of the Ellora. And this is from the Patadakal temple. And this is again from Ellora. This is not as a sculpture on the wall, but this sculpture is right there on the roof. Right on top of the roof it is there. This is a beautiful Lalita Tandava posture of Shiva on the roof. Again, this is the Nulumba temple at Nandi near Bangalore. This is again a Lalita pose. And look at this. What an amazing Lalita dance of Shiva doing it in the elephanta. This is an amazing, outstanding sculpture, I would say. Unfortunately, the Portuguese have blasted using the cannons and everything is destroyed below the waist. And you cannot make it as Lalita. But why we say still a Lalita? Because the features of this particular thing, assuming that some other place it is like this, so this should be Lalita. What an amazing representation. What an amazing representation of art. I'll tell you, You will bleed. Your eyes will bleed when you go to Elephanta and see that marvel that has been created and destroyed. What a marvel that has been created that's also been destroyed. You will bleed. And again, the Orissa temples, the Kalinga, you find this Nateshwara and Lalita pose in most of the temple, facades of it, all the temples. Again, this is the Lalita pose of Shiva in the famous Chidambaram temple, one of the gopurams of the Chidambaram temple. Again, this is one of the North Indian temples in Rajasthan where Shiva is doing the Lalita dance, holding the snake, and the Rishabha is also by the side of Shiva. And this is again a different thing. Lalita, by just the look of it, you can think it is Lalita, but it's called as Swastika Tandavam. What is the difference between Lalita and this is it's a Karna representation where the two legs are crossed at the front or at the back, creating a swastika pose. Normally, when the two legs are kept together, it is Lalita. When they are crossed, brought in like this, cross across each other, either in the front or back, it's called as swastika. And there's a beautiful representation of bronze somewhere very close to Chennai only in this. I forgot the name of this temple. And this is again a very beautiful Lalita swastika pose of Shiva Nataraja in the temple of Kivelur. Kivelur is about 5-6 kilometers from Tiruvarur. A beautiful madakoil, fully built of granite, and wonderful temple, Akshayalingam is the temple Shiva there. And here, Nataraja is in this posture with at least 20 bronzes around him. You will never see that representation. See here, Shiva is there with Shivakama Sundari, Ganesha is there, Subramanya is there, Mahavishnu is playing the drum, Brahma is playing the, the cymbals, Rishis are there, Ganas are there, so many things, about 20 bronzes around that in different levels. It's amazing to see this. This is a temple and this bronze is still under the worship. It's from the Kivalur temple. And the cross-like position is known as Katihas Katisamam in the Natya Shastra. Again, a beautiful representation by the Rajasimha in his temple of Kailashnatha of this Swastika Tandavam. This is a very rare phenomenon that you could see either a sculpture or as a bronze. But people trying to understand between the mistake between Lalita and the Swastika. Swastika is very rare. And Nataraja dancing in Lalita with multiple arms and upper two arms holding a long snake. This is not a very common feature in the Dravida Desa, but this is seen more in the Odisha and the north. And what you see here is the Rawalpahadi temple at Aihole, where Nataraja is dancing. What is so special and what is the beauty of this is that this Nataraja is seen here dancing with Saptamatrikas. This Nataraja dancing with Saptamatrikas is a cult of the Kapalika sect, which was followed in Saivism at one point of time. So there the Matrikas worship was also concerned along with Shiva. And Shiva is shown here dancing with the Saptamatrikas. Look at this, Saptamatrikas on either side of Shiva. And this is an intense form of tantric worship, where Nateshwara with Matrikas is seen in the Chalukyan and Rashtrakutan temples. Basically, the Shiva with the Matrikas are shown in Rashtrakutas and the Chalukyan temples, which is again an intense form of the Kapalika set of worship. And I would say this wonderful Gachasamhara Murthy at Ellora, cave number 16, this Samhara itself is a dance. You will find the Saptamatrikas, all the heads being chopped down below. They are also supposed to be dancing along with Shiva. Shiva worship with Saptamatrikas was a very important feature of those particular days of Kapalika sect, and it was followed in many places. Now, Kalinga countries in the northeast region, Shakta cult is very, very prominent. Devi is worshipped with 64 Yogini Devis, and they are called the Chaushat Yogini or Chatushashti Yogini, and the Yoginis are always arranged in a circular form, and the worship is offered to them, and they call it as Mahashakti and do this. This is a Shakta cult of worship which was going on in the Kalinga country. And you have many such temples all over the Kalinga region. And what is the beauty here is, the center thing is not Shakti, it is Nateshwara. Nateshwara with the Chitra Tandava and Urdhulinga is there, and he is worshipped as Shakti there, which very clearly brings out the phenomenon of Shivashakti Aikya Swarupam. Shiva and Shakti are one and the same. The Shivashakti Aikya Swarupam is what is there as Natesha, and Nateshwara is worshipped there in the Shakta cult in this particular temple. Now, Kashmir Shaivism is a non-dualistic and tantric Shaivism which was founded in 850, and it differs from the Shaiva Siddhanta. This is more an Advaitic form of Shaivism, and which is still practiced in Bengal, Odisha and Maharashtra regions. Here, in Kashmir Shaivism, it is more the Kapalika cult was based on this Shaivism. The Shiva images are shown with the erect phallus, which is an indication of omnipotent and creative nature of Shiva. The featuring of the Urdhvalinga is defined as an indication or the state of perpetual celibacy. Shiva is always in bliss. That is what has been indicated with the Urdhvalinga. Shiva is known as the supreme, and he is supposed to be having control over the entire physical desires of life. And that's what is the representation see here. Shiva is represented with Urdhvalinga, are seen in many sculptures across the Gupta, Kalinga and the Pala regions of their temples and the sculptures. Nateshwaras of Orissa or the Kalinga Desa are totally different. They are all never shown in Ananda Tandava pose. They are all seen more like this, is what is there. Every temple, the facade, the front side of the front, the entrance of the temple, you have the Nateshwara being depicted in different forms. Look at the Nateshwara sculptures. Amazing sculptures of Nateshwara seen there. Especially in the Mukteshwara temple in Bhuvaneshwar, you find beautiful Nateshwara right on the top of the Vimana. He is depicted in different levels, and what a beautiful Nateshwara, look at that. Right on top of the Vimana. And Nataraja is seen above Surya on the face of the Vimana of Baital temple at Bhuvaneshwar. This is a very, very rare and has got a great significance to this. Surya is the high energy Rudra, and he is always equated to Surya. Rudra is always equated to Surya in the Vedic hymns of Satarudriyam. You all know about it. Now, the emergence of Surya on the eastern sky of Akasha in the early morning dispels the darkness and supporting activity starts. For every life, the cycle begins then. Nateshwara in the form of Rudra dances in the Akasha, and his dance, there is not one that controls the complete functioning of the universe, and that happens, and that is Nateshwara shown with Surya. Now, Nataraja seen above the image of Dakshinamurti is again a very rare thing to see in the temple Vimanas and Koshtas. And mostly we don't notice also. And this is the temple of Isalam where you have this Nataraja on top of the Dakshinamurti. Dakshinamurti is a symbol of Jnana seated under the banyan tree with the Sanakati rishis below him and giving the Upadesha in silence. Dispelling the ignorance and imparting the knowledge And this happens totally in a very serene atmosphere, which is quiet and tranquil. On the contrary, the Tandava of Shiva is loud and vibrant, where he dispels the Maya and the ignorance and shows the way of Ananda, or the knowledge or the bliss. It's very simple in our scientific way to say, the static or dynamic energy is one and the same. Energy is one and the same whether it is static or dynamic. It's just energy is energy, all powerful and all providing. That's what has been referred here. Nateshwara of Pala region, the Bengal region under the Pala dynasty had worshipped Shiva as Nirtheshwara, Bhairava, Kankala and Virupaksha. Shiva was always shown dancing on top of the bull in Lalita, and he is seen with multiple hands of 8 or 10 and holding different weapons. The upper two arms are always shown above the head in a clapping mode. And this shows that the upper two hands are always keeping up the thala of the dance of Nateshwara. Shiva is always shown with the Urdhulinga, which is again the following of the Tantric Saivism of Kashmir. Look at this wonderful image of Nataraja in Pala image. Nirtheshwara sculptures of Pala shown playing Veena and representing the supreme knowledge. He is called the Sarvagya. Sarvagya, this dance of omniscience, is Nataraja, who is shown as a Veena Dara, that it represents the supreme knowledge of music and dance. The position of Shiva's dance known as Vaishakasthana, the upper hands in the clapping mode of the tala and the ones holding a big snake, is always seen with his two consorts of Ganga and Gauri on either side of this image. What a wonderful bronze image of the Pala, which is now under the worship in the temple of Melakkadambur. What a beautiful image. Amazing man, the multi-armed Pala Nataraja, seen with a sword in his hand, is just exemplified. Shiva is the destroyer of all the fears, especially the Adhyatmika, the Bhautika, and Adhivaitika. In other words, the flashing of the sword also cuts the deep-rooted ignorance, and the sword also represents the knowledge. The absence of Apasmara Purusha is shown as Maya, and the action drives away all the ignorance. This is what is seen there in the Pala. Outstanding Pala bronze, which is now in workshop in the Melakkadambur. This is just a bronze which is not more than 18 inches, a very small one, which is still under the worship there in the temple. This is brought as a war booty by Rajendra Chola from the Pala region when he conquered the Palas and brought the Ganga from that region. He brought this wonderful thing. Rajendra had a beautiful eye for collecting wonderful things. He brought several wonderful things like that. And this is one of the beautiful Pala bronze image which is there in the Velakadambur temple. The beauty of this is that Shiva is dancing on top of a bull and with 10 arms, holding different weapons and dancing. On either side you have the Ganga and Gauri, Ganesha, Subramanya, and Ashtabhairavas are also dancing. So many images, all in that 1.5 foot image, this bronze image of that. This is taken out on the every Pradosham, and they do the Pradoshakala Puja for that. Amazing to see that, and the crowd there and the way in which they are chanting the Namah Shivaya and the pujas that has been afforded to this image. I'll tell you, it is a mind-boggling thing to be there and to witness this in Melakkadambur. And the temple itself is so beautiful. Look at this. Look at the back posture of Nataraja. Look at that. What a beautiful Pala image. Pala bronze that is being given. And Urdhva Janu, this is again, Shiva's 1 foot is raised above the navel, and that is called as Urdhva Janu. This is again a different Karana pose. And most of the sculptures that you find in the North Indian temples and some of the temples here are also in Urdhva Janu. That was what you saw in the Pallava bronze. And now here you see this bronze in Urdhva, sculpture in Urdhva Janu from the Rajasthan region. And this is from the temple of Kailashnatha. And this is again a beautiful Urdujanu sculpture which is seen from the temple of Pullamangai, where Shiva is dancing in Urdujanu. And again, this is a beautiful representation of Urdujanu in the miniature sculpture that is found on the pillar of the great temple of Srinivasanallur, Kuraknatha temple at Srinivasanallur, and one from the beautiful Patavatakal temple of Chalukyas. Lalata Tilakam. This is again one more dance posture where the hand is also going up along with the leg and he does the Tilaka pose. This is again a beautiful Lalata Tilakam, is again a pose. And look at this, a rare bronze of Nataraja with the folded right leg parallel to the ground. The left leg is on top of Apasmara, who is not lying onto the side, but straight. The usual Abhaya Mudra is missing and is shown as a Kataka Mudra. Both the ears have Patra Kundala and not the Makara and Patra Kundala. The usual Jata Mukutam is missing. The flowing Jatas are not there. Instead, it's seen with a crown. This is the Vakkara Nataraja of Tiruvakkare. In this temple, everything is Vakram. So, I don't know what is the reason it is made. This neither falls into the Agamic text or not falls into the Silpa Shastra text or anything. But this is called as Vakkara Nataraja. One and the only such Nataraja in this whole world. If you go to this temple, you can never see this. It's always under the shutter. You will have to be satisfied by seeing the old archive pictures from the French Institute. Unless you are a big VIP, they will never open up the door to show you this wonderful Nataraja. I know that is the way in which they are protecting it. And again, this is a different pose of Nataraja, which is called Garuda something in this Kanchipuram temple. And such wonderful Natarajas of different styles, which you find in the Ellora, and you find it in across the many places. This is again the Kalmari Adiya Tandavam of Madurai. And look at the way this is again a beautiful Nataraja, which is totally mutilated in the Kajurago temple. All the 8 arms are chopped. The head is also chopped, the leg is also chopped. Look at that, the face and the back should be always in the straight, like what you see in the Gatsamara Murthy. Unfortunately, today you can see only a very crude representation of this. I mean, it's very painful to see. Again, the Samhara Murthy is the Kalasamhara Murthy of the Kailashnatha temple. I'm going a bit fast. Again, this is the Halibedu, Shiva's Samhara Murthy. And this is again one more Samhara Murthy of the temple. And this is the most beautiful Gajasamhara Murthy. What a beautiful Gajasamhara Murthy bronze, which is under worship at the Valuvur temple. Shiva goes inside the elephant, and then he just grows by the size. He tears the skin of that elephant, he emerges out as if he's just coming out like that. And that is a dance. What Shiva did by Samhara of Gaja is a dance. It is just not something, a Samhara or a what you call a war scene or anything. It's a dance by itself, he did it. And that's a beautiful representation of Gajasamhara Murthy as a Chola bronze, still under worship in the temple of Valuvur. And look at this Tripura Tandava Murthy. Tripura Tandavam in the Kudumbalur temple. Again, Kalasamhara Murthy from the Kudumbalur. And this is the Belur. Gajasamhara Murthy, Andhakasura Samhara Murthy, and some other Samhara Murthy here. And you have the Gajasamhara Murthy again in a different form, given from the Belur temple. And Bhairava is shown as dancing. Samhara Bhairava is shown as dancing Bhairava here. And you have different dance in form of Natesha. Nataraja is also been worshipped in paintings from those days. What you see here is a painting that you, which is totally gone from the temple of Panamalai, which was created by Rajasimha. Today you can see the traces of lines alone of Nataraja's hand, Gajahasta, and few arms spread across. The entire painting is totally lost, and today we have only faint lines of this particular past, which is there in Panamalai. And what a beautiful creation of Chidambaram Nataraja, the scene of Chidambaram where Nataraja is dancing in the golden hall, Rajaraja with his wives are offering, is offering his tributes to Nataraja. There's a beautiful painting of Nataraja depicted in the great temple of Tanjavur. Again, you have this wonderful Nataraja image right with the fragments of painting seen on the top of the Ellora cave number 16 at the Kailash temple of the Rashtrakutas, Nateshwara and Rashtrakutas, and of course the Kerala paintings, most modern versions and the old versions are there, where you have Nateshwara being represented with multiple arms and dancing. And this is what you see, the Nataraja in many places over the thing in paintings. Not only here, Nateshwara is represented across the world. In Bentisarai temple at the Cambodia, Nateshwara is seen dancing right on the top of the Vimana, just to depict that he is the one who dances in the Akasha, and that's what is seen. And not only Natesha is there, Karakalamayar is also there. She is just there down below playing the cymbals for the Nateshwara's dance. And the cosmic dance of Nateshwara, in whichever form of Tandava he is represented, as a sculpture or bronze in our temples, there is no match to the most beautiful representation of Ananda Tandava bronzes, created by the great Cholas from the 10th century, which is again a representation of vibrant action of dance fused in one, symbolizing the atom and the universe. Thousands of such wonderful Natarajas were created by the unknown artists under the Cholas for over 400 years and were installed in the temples that have captivated the devotees by the sheer beauty and the magnificence and the philosophy of Shaiva Siddhanta. Thoduday Shivyan Vidayerum Thuven Madhishudi காடுடைய சுடலை பொடி பூசி என் உள்ளம் கவர் கல்வன். திருஞான சம்பந்தர் சேஸ், என் உள்ளம் கவர்ந்த கல்வன், த தீஃப் ஹூ ஸ்டோல் மை ஹார்ட். ஹீ இஸ் த தீஃப் ஹூ ரியலி ஸ்டோல் மை ஹார்ட், மை நட்ராஜா ஆஃப் மை மேலே சிதம்பரம் அட் பேரூர். அண்ட் டு ஹிம் ஐ ப்ரே அண்ட் கிவ் திஸ் ப்ரெசன்டேஷன் ஆஸ் எ மை ட்ரிபியூட் டு ஹிம். தேங்க்யூ. Any questions? I'm prepared to take it.
Yes, sir.
Clarification, not question.
Yes, please.
We receive a lot of messages saying that the tip of the toe of Nataraja in
Chidambaram
is supposed to be the center of the universe.
Yes.
Is there any reference to it?
I'll tell you.
In inscription or in Vedic times or in literature?
Scientifically also, the magnetic line, the center line, the equator, magnetic equator, is just goes across the septumbrum. That's what they say. That's why Chidambaram is said as the heart of the Virata Purusha, Hridayasthanam of the Virata Purusha. And Chidambaram has got its significance. Scientifically, it's also been proved to be very close to that. If you're saying whether tip or anything, that may be an exaggeration or anything. But Chidambaram has got that particular greatness. It is the center point of the magnetic force of this earth.
Any reference to it?
Yeah, there are plenty of references. You can just see, you can Google and see it. Plenty of things are there. Yeah.
How do modern physics?
I told you, no? It's very clearly, I told you, no? How Tao of physics, Ferdows Capra has very clearly said, he says the dance of Shiva denotes not only the, what you call, destruction, it also goes to creation. Similarly, the dance of Shiva is also the multifold, no? Destruction for creation. So it is a multifold thing. Not only the human thing, or thing, even subatomic matter happens that way. So that is the dance. The physics also have proved this. After everything, it goes like this. So he says very clearly. Yeah. Tao of physics very clearly explains, and that's why they have this image of Nataraja at the wonderful place CERN. 6 foot Nataraja, which was donated by the government of India. Anything else?
ஒரு சங்கடமான ஒரு இதை கொடுக்கணும். ஏன்னா இந்த ஸ்டேஜ் இது ஒரு ஸ்டேஜ் ஆடித்தாருன்னா நடராஜர் எல்லா இடத்துலையுமே டான்ஸ் ஆடிட்டு இருந்தார். ஒரு குருமூர்த்தி சார் வந்து ரொம்ப பிரயாசப்பட்டு நிறைய இடத்துக்கு போய் நிறைய அனுபவித்து சொன்னதை நமக்கு ஒரு ஒரு 1.5 மணி நேரத்தை சொன்னது எங்களுக்கெல்லாம் ரொம்ப தேங்க்ஸு. நீங்கள் வந்திருந்து இதெல்லாம் ஆனந்ததுக்கு உங்களுக்கும் ஒரு ஒரு அற்புதமான அனுபவம். Thank you very much.